What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCP Euro DIY. Today, we're going to be working on a 2018 Volkswagen Atlas. Today on the Atlas behind me, we're going to be covering how to service your Haldex system. In front of us, we have a Fevi service kit, which is available on fcpro.com. We have a couple different versions of this kit, but today we're going to be running with the Fevi one. It includes everything you need to do this DIY. Volkswagen recommends this service to be done every 3 years, regardless of mileage. If you wanted to put a mileage number on it, 40,000 is your max, but every 3 years, this should be done. This is going to be applicable to all your Atlas, whether it's the 2-liter four-cylinder or the six-cylinder like the one behind us. But before we get started on this, let's take a look at some of the tools we're going to need for this DIY. For today's DIY, we're going to be using a basic amount of tools. We have a small 3/8 drive torque wrench, same with a regular ratchet and a quarter-inch ratchet, small pick tool. We have a small extension for our quarter-inch ratchet. As far as sockets go, we have a 10 mil, we have an 8 millimeter hex, we have a 5 millimeter hex and a T10. We have some brake cleaner to clean out the screen on our pump. We have, speaking of pumps, a CTA. This is 7073. This is a smaller version of what's included in the larger all-inclusive Haldex service kit, which you will see on fcpro.com. It's just a little bit easier to work with and it'll be perfect for what we're doing today. And during the filling process, we're gonna have to check the fluid temperature on our Haldex system. So this Autel 808 is gonna come in handy. Other things needed but not pictured here, obviously some shop towels, a catch pan for the old oil. We're gonna be catching it in a pitcher just to see what it looks like and seeing how much of it comes out. And with that, let's go ahead and get started on this DIY. All right, my good people, we are under the Atlas. First thing, one of the most important things to note is whenever you're doing this kind of surface, whether it's on the Haldex, the rear diff, or the transfer case, bevel box, if you will, transmission, the car needs to be level. So whether you're on the lift, you're in the driveway, you're in the garage, shop floor, whatever it may be, just make sure the vehicle's level. It's gonna affect how you fill the vehicle's system back up or the casing back up. So you don't wanna cheap out on that step, if you will. To get started with any service like this, we're always gonna make sure that the fill plug will come out first. That way we're not stuck with an empty case and no ability to fill it. So we're gonna grab our 5 millimeter hex. For the Haldex system, the fill plug is located right up here on the top. Our drain plug is located on the front side. The differential fluid itself is its own system, if you will, its own side of things. That's gonna sit kind of underneath and behind the axle. So that's a DIY for another day. Something we recommend you do both at the same time, which will also be uploaded on the channel if you wanna check that one out. So just be sure if you're doing a drain and fill for the Haldex that you are doing the correct fill plug and drain plug. You don't want to accidentally drain the diff and vice versa. Leave one system empty. So we're going to grab our 5 mil hex. I just have a quarter inch ratchet. With these, you want to make sure that you get them situated all the way in. Super important. And then we can just break it free. And I'm going to go ahead and remove it all the way now. That way the case can breathe as we drain out the Haldex fluid. Now we're gonna grab our 8 millimeter hex and same deal. Just gonna make sure that that sits all the way in there as best as possible. And we'll go ahead and crack it free. Then I'm gonna grab, for our sake today, just a pitcher to catch the fluid in. We'll see how much comes out and we'll see what color this looks like. Now this car has 61,000 miles. It was just purchased by one of our team members in the distribution center. So we're not sure if it's had any real service before him buying it just a couple weeks ago. So we're just gonna kind of go through it and do a little check and see what a 60,000 mile or so we think Haldex system looks like. And yeah, this was definitely not changed. It's not horrible looking, but compared to the fluid that we're gonna be putting in, this is, you can already tell, quite dark. So we're gonna give this a minute to drain and then we're gonna move on to the pump itself. We'll show you how to pull that out. We're gonna take it over to the workbench to clean it out properly, clean the screen. You could do it while hanging here in the underside of the car, but realistically, you don't wanna put any weird stress on the harness or anything like that. So we'll show you how to get that out and on the table in just a moment. All right, we've let this drip for quite a while here in the shop. I'm gonna go ahead and throw in the new drain plug now, just get that situated so it's not just forever and eternally slowly dripping here. There's really not anything left in here that we're gonna be able to get out. So we're gonna start threading our new one in by hand. Let's give this a little wipe. We'll hit it with some brake cleaner once we do our fill procedure. I'm gonna get some fluid everywhere, I'm sure. We're gonna grab our 8mm hex and our torque wrench, and we're gonna snug this baby up to 32 Newton meters. There we go. All right, now that that's situated, we're gonna leave the system empty for now. We're gonna move over to the pump, but before we get to the pump, let's just go ahead and tackle the connector, which sits right up top here. You're not gonna be able to see too much from here, but it's a standard VAG style connector, the ones we all love. So we'll go ahead and get that disconnected. We have a harness that runs over the diff casing with a built-in, if you will, plastic guide that has two little alligator style pinches on it that we're gonna push through the diff casing. We'll swing the harness over and then pull the pump out. On top of our controller here, you can see we have a small little black tab. These are the standard VAG connectors. I always recommend you push down on the tab to release the clip, push the whole connector into the module and then back. It'll help release the little hook. And as we follow that back, you'll see the harness goes to this, like a little black guide bracket. And on the other side of it, you can just push through the little two pinch ends that kind of just open up. They're like little forks that go through the casing that hold this in place. So. Nothing really rocket science here, but let's go ahead and unplug the connector first. All right, we're having a hard time with this clip, which is pretty standard for Volkswagen connectors. So what we're gonna do is just use the old pick, which is always tried and true. Just be mindful, you can damage stuff doing it like this. You can break the clip, so. Just be very careful. We're just gonna shove it on there, kind of get a feel for where that tab is, free up that tab, and then we can work this connector off. All right, with that undone, now we can start popping this harness off of the diff casing. So you can see on the other side, where the harness kind of ends and goes into this plastic little guide. On the opposite side, there's these two little forks. He's gonna push those in by hand, kind of push them together. You can push them through the diff casing. Okay. Once you push them through, then you can pull it through the other side. We have one more on the opposite side near the pump. Let's get that one freed now. We have one more right here. This one's right above the pump, a lot easier to see. Pop this baby through. Okay. All right. We have two 10mm bolts that hold our pump to our casing. We're just gonna take our 10 on our 1/4-inch ratchet and break these babies free. We have new ones of these included in the kit, so don't worry about misplacing these or losing them. They're not torqued to yield, but Volkswagen recommends to have them replaced and they come part of the service kit. Now, whatever you do as you remove this pump, do not pry between the casing and the pump, or you can risk damaging the mating surface and then that can cause potential leaks. Even though there is two O-rings there, you just don't wanna allow anything to come in or out. We're just gonna use our hands to kind of twist the pump off of the casing here. And I'm gonna do my best to catch the fluid that comes off of there as well. Oh yeah, she's looking a little nasty. So here we can see the two O-rings, which just go flat naturally over time. You can see all the gunk that's built up on the screen of this filter pump. So that's what we're gonna be taking off and cleaning. And then inside of the actual casing, you're gonna wanna clean that as well, using some shop towel, something that's lint free, because there's gonna be quite a bit of material on there. Let's see if I can do it with this finger. You can see just some clutch material and debris that's suspended in the fluid there. So that's why you want to kind of give this all a good wipe, give it a good chance, and give the new fluid a longer chance at life before everything goes back together. And just for what it's worth, we have just less than a liter of fluid. We have about 765 milliliters of fluid, which is what came out of our whole system. So again, just under a liter. So you have more than enough fluid just buying the kit that comes with the 1 liter. All right, with this wiped off, we're gonna keep the catch pan under here. Let's head over to the workbench real quick. We'll show you how to get that screen off, replace the O-rings, clean it out, and then we'll throw it back in the car. Over at the table, we're gonna use our T10 bit on our quarter inch ratchet. We have 2 T10s to remove. That'll get us this screen element off of the pump. And these 2 bolts we will be reusing. All right, and then we can pull the screen off. Just gently, there's 2 little dowel pins that kind of hold it together. First thing we're gonna clean out, we're gonna clean it out from both directions using some brake cleaner. I'm just gonna go over my trash bin and spray it out. All right, so tackling it from both sides, we'll get anything trapped in the screen element out. Now we're gonna very gently pick out the old O-rings, being careful not to mar up the surface that they sit in. So we're just gonna use our pick. Very gently pop one out. We'll pop the second one out. And then similar to the screen over the trash bin, without trying to introduce brake clean into the pump, we're just gonna clean out the surrounding edges where the seals sit and any gunk that may be on the body. All right, that looks much, much better. It's surprising how much gunk just stays in the inside of the body here. So definitely want to stay on top of this service every 3 years, or again, 40,000 miles, but I would stick to 3 years, whether you're hitting that 40 mark or not. Okay, with that cleaned up, we can now install our new O-rings. Pretty straightforward. We'll just pull them over the body. Make sure you're getting them in the proper channel here. You don't want to get them post or before it. Otherwise, it won't seal properly. All right. Now we can grab our screen and feed that baby back over once more, just like so. We'll take our 2 T10s, get these babies started by hand, and then we'll snug them up using the ratchet. Very gently, you don't need to go too hard on these. They are very tiny pieces of hardware. So just once they snug up, that's all you need. All right, don't forget to lubricate your O-rings. Use some of the fresh Haldex fluid. And now with that, let's head over to the vehicle and get this baby back in place. All right, our Haldex is gonna go back in, harness facing up. O-rings are nice and lubed up. Oh yeah, baby, no problem. Give it a little twist as she goes in. Just push this out of our way. We can feed that harness over. We can go ahead and clip in the first one here of our little plastic guide, just so it's out of our hair. Now we have 2 10-millimeter bolts that secure the pump to the casing. Again, new ones included in the kit. And then both of these 10 mil get torqued down to 9.5 Newton meters. So let's set the torque wrench to stun, and then we'll snug them up. There's 2. I'm just gonna paint mark these so that we know they're done. Now let's hop over to the other side. We'll plug in the harness, get that guide clipped in, and then we can fill this baby up with some fluid, or do the initial fill, if you will. Now we can clip in our guide back into the casing. Up top, push that baby through. Then we can plug in our electrical connector once more. All right, with our harness plugged back in, now we can start filling the casing up with fluid. So we're gonna take our pump and we're gonna start filling it until it starts to dribble out of the fill hole. And then we're gonna use the old plug just so we don't ruin the seal on the new one and just snug it up. We're gonna hop inside the car, check the temp on the Haldex system. And as long as we're in a certain range, which we'll cover up top, then we can go ahead and either warm it up a little bit to let that pump prime and get fluid through it. So that will take up some of that level up and then we can refill after that. So we'll cover all that in just a moment. But for now, let's just fill until we start getting a dribble and then we'll put the plug in temporarily and hop inside the car. That's exactly what we want to see. So try not to be wasteful again. We have just under a liter in our bottle. Granted, this takes much less than that. So now we're going to take our old plug. We're just going to snug that up super gently. You don't need to go crazy with it. So now with that, let's hop inside the car. We'll get the autel going and we'll show you how to check the temp so that we can continue filling this up properly. Now we're inside the vehicle. We have our autel hooked up, ignition on, the car still off. We've selected Volkswagen on the 808. We're just going to run the automatic selection, which will read the VIN for us. We can hit OK. And then once that is done, it'll give us 2018 Atlas, all that good juice. We'll hit yes on that. All right, with that, then we're going to go to diagnosis. Then we're going to do control unit. And that'll allow us to select just what we want to look at right now. We don't want to look at every single thing on the car. So we're going to go to what is either going to be all-wheel drive electronics and or the all-wheel drive control system. Let's see what we have here. So that's going to be menu 22, all-wheel drive electrics. Go ahead and click on that. And now we want to look at the live data. In order to get the proper fill on this, the housing or the Haldex system needs to be between 20 to 40 degrees Celsius. So as long as we're in that range, we're going to be perfectly fine to fill it. In this case, we are at 20 degrees Celsius exactly. So what I'm going to do just to get the prime pumped is I'm going to start the vehicle, shift it through the gears for a moment. Again, all four wheels have to be in the air. Again, the car has to be level. So make sure you're good there and make sure it's supported properly. We're gonna go ahead and run it for just a minute or two, no more than that. That'll keep us still within the Celsius window and it'll allow the pump to prime. Then we'll hop back underneath the vehicle and top it off as needed. All right, at this point, we let the car just idle and drive. Temperature went up a degree or two. That's perfectly fine. We're still within the 20 to 40. Now we're going to hop back underneath, top off as needed. Again, we're just going to fill it until it starts to drip out, and then we should be good to rock and roll. We'll take our 5 mil hex, get that baby snugged in there, break this old drain plug free. Again, we use the old one just so that we don't ruin the seal on the new one doing this. Okay, that's good. We don't have fluid bulging out, which is good news. We still have a little bit left in our syringe. Let's just see if it takes any more than that. We have about 70 liters left in the syringe here. So before I add any more to it, we're just gonna feed it in, see if it takes all of that. There we go. That's exactly what we wanna see, baby. So it took another bit there and now it's starting to drip out. That's exactly what we want. We have just under 100 liters left in the bottle. So that's good. We're right within what we drained out of it. Now we can take our new plug, feed that baby in, 5 millimeter hex. And now with that, we're gonna torque this 5 mil hex bolt to 15 Newton meters. Boom, baby. Now we're just gonna hit everything with a little bit of brake clean, get this oil residue off. And that, my good people, that's gonna conclude this DIY for today. Overall, a really easy and straightforward DIY on the Atlas and MQB chassis for that matter. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave those in the comment section below. If you want to see more DIYs like this, we're going to be doing quite a few on this chassis. Please consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.